Good evening and welcome to Legacy Hall. At this time, we ask that you please silence all cell phones and any other noise-making devices. If you must leave, please do so during the applause or in between pieces. Lastly, any unauthorized audio or video recording is strictly prohibited. Thank you and enjoy the performance.
Thank you. was told I needed to speak into the same part of the live stream.
Normally I just project, you know.
So it's so great to be here. So great to be back in a town that, well, I've known pretty well because I actually went to undergrad here. You know, it's so great to see, you know, new faces as well as many old faces, and to get to play what I consider really awesome new music for hopefully very open ears. So bear with us. Some pieces might get a little weird, but that's okay. But not this one. This one's not weird. Okay, so this next piece on the program is written by a very dear friend and also Schwob alum named Nathan Hudson. And, you know, I think playing this piece is a perfect example of what I wanted to do when I first came up with the idea for Unheard-of. The idea is there are a lot of really, really talented composers, and we just need people to play awesome music like Nathan's work. And, you know, one thing that I think is really important is the inspirational aspect of this. I mean, I probably would not have been a clarinet major if it wasn't for hearing Dr. O at Georgia Honor Band's play E-Type Jag by Jim David. It's the weirdest thing. Who would have thought that hearing like that one performance would make me go, wow, I really should think about actually making this a career. It's weird.
Thank you.
Snatched away by the devil, and how her mother searched for her over the hills of the world.
Mm-hmm.
great performance this evening will be given with words.
You're going to show me.
On with the play. But don't forget to bring your rich aunts. Lake of wrath was seen floating arms and legs. All that were left of Abraham, Penelope, and Jephthah's daughter, Midas, Harlequin, beside the lake Proserpina strayed, robed in bluish black as one anticipating grief. Satan stealthily approached her. Proserpina threw up her arms, ran to him, and buried her face in his scarlet bosom.
Thank you.
You see, the devils rolled into the lake. Proserpina was struck by a falling cloud, and Demeter looks on with staring eyes the ills of her daughter.
End of play. to attempt acting. I'll never say I'm an actor. And I would have to sing while playing, so that's been fun to do that. This next piece is by a composer that I've worked with for a while now throughout my master's degree and now the past few years. He's from Utah, and that's where I'm from as well. We've done a lot of arrangements, original works, put a lot of concerts together, so it's been really fun to also bring new arrangements to my repertoire. This next piece, we've really enjoyed playing all the extended techniques and really exploring new sounds and new textures within the ensemble. And the piece is programmatic about the assassination of JFK. It's about a short video clip that shows the assassination, so keep your ears tight for what you can imagine in the piece. And thank you again for coming.
Thank you.
next work is by Howard Kenty, who we got a chance to work with. Actually, basically, almost all of the composers on this program we've been able to work with at Stony Brook University and other places. So we were very excited to be able to work with the composers and also get the opportunity to perform it so many times on this tour. We feel like it really brought us closer to the music, and we're happy to do that, and we're looking forward to the next season. You know, with new composers, new music, it's very exciting. So, the next work, Howie's piece, is, as the title suggests, a kind of colorful, dreamy piece.
Thank you.
So, first off, I'd like to thank Dr. Oberlander and Dr. Harris for having me here and having, like, our weird, kooky project at this incredible hall. You know, it's great to come back here, and it's also great to, you know, revisit old friends. You know, I went to school with Boris, and somehow, outside of orchestra, I really never got to play any chamber music with him. And I took his photos, took some headshots for him last semester of undergrad here, and I said to him, why haven't we played together? We need to play together soon. And I can't believe it's taken 3 years to be able to, like, get back together and reconnect with him, but I'm so excited to get to play with my good friend here. So I'd love to welcome to the stage Boris.
Thank you.